Jameson Park. I think they're already inside.
They're dressed like you. They're not inside.
Hey, what about me? If you could just check your list.
Hey, look, lady, can you step back from the road, please?
Hey, Nikki. Hey. Looking good.
Thanks.
But this car is a disaster.
Maybe you can find me a new one when I come out?
Anything for you.
I'll wipe it off.
Hey, Jimmy, it's me.
I'm sorry. Excuse me, I'm sorry. Oh, God, don't move, you'll tear it.
I think my hair's caught on your pin.
Easy.
Okay, there.
God, thanks, you saved my life. This dress has got to go back to the store tomorrow.
Are you alone tonight, Nikki?
Not exactly. Hey, how long have you been trying to get in?
Forget it, I really want to go home.
No,
thanks.
Don't be silly, come on, come with me.
Excuse me. Okay, she's with me.
How am I supposed to know?
I'll get yours.
Put it away around here. It's going to be embarrassed if you see pay.
Hello, how are you?
Look, I'm Nikki.
Nicole Grace.
I'm Susan Warfield.
You just visiting L.A.?
No, I moved here a couple months ago from Houston. And some friends at work thought it was time that I get out for an evening.
Yeah, and then they don't show up. Some friends, huh? Here, try some of this. Actually, let me. It's what I do for a living anyway. Sit down. Close your eyes.
And I'm a makeup artist. Rock videos, commercials. Whatever comes up, really.
Wow.
It's much better.
We should let all those people in outside. There's not that many people here.
Yeah, but they always do that. I mean, give this place a month. It'll be dead. Watch.
You can really take that dress back after you've worn it?
Little trick. See that?
Ooh.
You've got a lot to learn. Come on.
Notice the guy over there in the white vest?
Yeah.
He had a quadruple bypass last August, right? Now he hits on everything that walks. Thumped his wife and kids. He's a real loser. Ooh. Come on. Let's go up to the VIP section.
Nice.
You looking for somebody nice?
Honey, there are no real men in L.A.
All the guys out here hit on you right away. They think it's expected of them. You just have to put them in their place.
Don't you have any regular boyfriends back in Houston?
Well, there was Roy.
Mm-hmm.
He took off when my mom got sick. Then he shows up a couple of days after the funeral, heard that I'd sold the house, and suddenly he was just dying to marry me.
So you packed up and moved. You let him run you off.
No, I wanted to get away anyhow, you know, go someplace where I could start over.
Look, if you want things to be different, you've got to start being in control, instead of always heading for the nearest exit.
Hey, Nikki!
What?
Don't forget, 10 o'clock, Sunday night, Larry's house in Bel Air.
Yeah, I got it. Look, if you're not doing anything, there's this great bash in Bel Air on Sunday night. Lately, I can't get a job, but I'm on everybody's guest list.
Yeah, maybe I could go.
Do you have anything a little hotter to wear?
Well, you're welcome to come over to my house and look in my closet.
Not a chance.
Well, you know, I hadn't bought much clothes since my mom died. I always felt it was still her money. Did you see this?
Hey, is that her picture?
Yeah, she's about my age.
She's pretty. Is that your father?
You know, I never knew she kept a picture of him until I was going through things. And there it was.
He looks really nice.
Yeah, he took off when I was about two. He went to work on some oil rig in Florida. We never heard from him since.
Guess you don't have any brothers or sisters, though.
Nope, just me.
Did you ever think about him when you were growing up?
Nah. Hurt too much.
But you kept his photo. Do you have a glass of milk?
You have an ulcer, and you're still smoking and drinking. Avoid taking this medication with alcoholic beverages.
Look, it only flares up every once in a while. I'm fine.
What do your doctors say?
They say, pay the bill. Ulcers are for rich people. I can't afford that.
Come on, drink your milk.
Come on. We're going to go over to my place. We are going to create a new you. Come on.
Doesn't your landlord provide you with a gardener?
What landlord? This place belongs to a couple backup singers in a heavy metal band. They went on tour, so I inherited the key.
Which I always keep right here under this plant. That way I don't lose it.
No, that's dangerous.
Enter at your own risk.
Have you been robbed?
It always looks like this.
Oh.
I mean, come on, can I help it if there's not enough closet space? Guys take one look and they flee into the night.
So you live here alone?
Yeah, just me and my stuff. I mean, I can't help it. I accumulate things. I just can't see throwing anything away.
Ah, got it. Look, killed it.
What was my eyelash?
Oh, gosh.
I could have sworn it moved. Sorry.
Nicole, look at all these parking tickets. These can turn into warrants. You could get arrested.
Really?
Yes, ma'am.
Thanks for pointing that out.
See, I told you my stuff would fit you.
Yeah, you know, it's not really me.
Yeah, but, I mean, that's the idea. After a while, you'll even start to feel different.
Well, I'm kind of naked in here and...
Okay, wait. Here, try something else. How about this?
That's kind of cute.
We have to do something with your hair.
Not bad.
Hello, Susan speaking. Hey! No, I'll pick you up for a change. You drove all last week. Wow! It's the biggest house I've ever seen. So what does this Larry do?
Nobody knows. And nobody asks. Don't be nervous. Plenty of heavy hitters here tonight.
Yeah?
Come on.
Hey, did you notice my eye makeup is better?
Oh, you look great.
Thanks.
Hey, Lori.
Hi.
This is my friend Susan.
Nice to meet you, Susan.
Wow, I'm starving.
No, thank you.
Oh, thank you.
You don't need that.
I'm not your mother. You don't have to take care of me. God, I'm sorry. I didn't mean to hurt your feelings.
Oh, no. Get it.
Still friends?
Yeah, still friends.
What am I saying? You don't even know me?
Yes, I do. I know you're a good person.
Not a very good judge of character, are you?
What do you mean?
Care to know about the real Nikki? All those sordid little details? I got arrested 7 months ago for shoplifting. Costume, jewelry, makeup. God knows I don't need any more makeup. I couldn't make bail. So I went away for nearly a month. I was really ashamed of myself.
And you're still running around with parking tickets? You're gonna get picked up again.
Why do I do that to myself?
I don't know. But you know what? I'm not gonna let you do it anymore.
I mean, it's funny. Because I know everybody. And you're the only one I could tell.
What? What's wrong?
God, my stomach. I think I need to sit down.
Okay. Let's go. Got it. There's a sofa. I'm gonna take you to the emergency room.
What's the matter? Is she okay?
Yeah, she's fine. Thanks. Let's get your coat. Is it getting worse?
Oh, God, just get me there.
Thank you.
Hey,
almost there. Okay. Let me just sit you down, then I'll go get take care of everything. Right. Just stay in this. Excuse me, I hate to interrupt you, but my friend is having an ulcer attack.
Has she vomited up blood?
No, she hasn't.
Has she coughed up anything that looks like coffee grounds?
No, I don't think so.
All right, well, just fill out this form and have a seat over there, and we'll see you as soon as we can.
She's not able to walk.
Ever since my husband lost his job, we don't have no medical insurance.
I wish I could help, but I have to refer you to County General.
That place is like a zoo, full of homeless and drug addicts. You could wait all night.
There's really nothing I can do for you here. It's the rules.
Wait, what's happening? Where are we going?
Well, we have to go to County General.
No, you can't. Go sit down, please.
Really?
Okay.
Excuse me, sir. She's really sick. Can she sit down, please?
Thank you.
Thank you so much.
Okay. I knew they wouldn't help me.
They would if you had insurance. It's one thing I have plenty of from work.
What good's that?
Excuse me, she made a mistake. I need another one. Thank you.
What are you doing?
Just for tonight, you have to be me. Susan A. Warfield.
Are you crazy?
Birth date, August 20th, 1970.
No way, Susan. You'll get in trouble.
Shh. No one will ever find out. Things will get treated right away.
No way. Come on. We'll try to make it to the car. We will go down.
Nicole?
We'll go down.
Not a chance. Stay. No one's ever gonna know. This is gonna get you in. Okay, hold on.
I can't believe you're doing this. Thank you.
Excuse me. Here's her paperwork. And her insurance card.
Let me make a copy of her card.
How long will it be?
We'll call Miss Warfield as soon as we can.
Oh, God.
Just driver's license and Social Security. That's all they're going to ask you for.
I got it down.
Just keep looking at it.
Miss Warfield?
Right here.
We're ready for you now.
Leave your purse with me.
Are you waiting for Miss Warfield?
Yes, I am. How is she?
We've lavaged her stomach. There's no internal bleeding now, but the x-rays reveal perforations in the lining and air up underneath her diaphragm.
What does that mean?
It means we're going to have to admit her. A laparotomy is indicated, and we'll know more in the morning.
An operation? Can I see her?
Yeah, maybe you can calm her down. Yeah. Unfortunately, a young girl like that with an ulcer is probably under a lot of pressure. We'll take care of it. Order a type and screen on that blood?
Yes, doctor.
I want to go home.
There's nothing to worry about. If we have to go in, the incision won't be that bad. We'll clip the nerve causing the secretion of excess stomach acid, and this condition probably won't recur.
Thanks. You've got to get me out of here. The worst thing we can do is panic. They'll get suspicious, and then where will we be?
But they're talking about operating.
Look, you've got some of the finest doctors on staff here. You're lucky.
They're going to find out.
They won't. The worst part is over. You've been admitted. Look, my company has paid a fortune in medical. I've never used a dime. Shh. Nobody's gonna get hurt.
They're ready for her upstairs.
Hi, Susan. I'll talk to you in the morning. She'll be all right now. So, how long do you plan to keep her?
It's a standard procedure of maybe 3-4 days. A week, tops.
A week?
I hope it's not a serious operation.
No. Some female problems. Mm. But I'll be back in a week.
No, don't you worry about anything around here. Just relax and get better.
Thank you. I would appreciate it if you didn't mention the details to anyone. It's kind of personal.
I'll respect your privacy. Just check in with your voicemail at the office from time to time to pick up any messages.
Yes, sir.
I lucked out. There's nobody else in the room.
Great. Well, I took medical leave from work, and I'm going down to that place that you told me about in Scottsdale.
What, the Delray?
Yep.
Oh, you're gonna love it.
I figure that way I won't run into anyone here when I'm supposed to be in the hospital.
Hey, you know what? You should see the surgeon that came in to brief me. It's this Greek guy. He's about 6'2". He's divorced. He's definitely interested.
Yeah, well, don't you get interested, because remember, you're me.
What if somebody finds out?
I won't.
But what if somebody phones the room?
Will you tell the nurses that you're not accepting any calls, period?
But then how am I going to talk to you?
Call me in Scottsdale. You're going to be out of there before I even get back.
God, Susan. I mean, nobody's ever done anything like this for me before. Ever. Not even my own family. Look, I just wanted to tell you that I'll always be there for you. Always.
Bye, Susan.
Bye-bye, Nikki.
Hi, yes, this is Bungalow 7. I'd like to make another credit card call to Los Angeles, please.
Okay, go ahead. Mercy Hospital.
Hi, third floor nurse's station, please.
One moment, please. Nurse's station.
Yes, I've called several times about Susan Warfield, and I can't seem to get any information.
Well, we're not permitted to give out information about a patient.
Listen, I know she's not taking any calls, but could you just tell me if she's been released yet?
Who is this, please?
I'm a friend. Is there something the matter? I know she had an operation on Monday.
Just a moment.
Now, who is this speaking, please?
What's going on? I just want to know if Susan Warfield's been released.
I really need for you to identify yourself. Hello?
You can just put that suitcase in the back seat, please.
Right away.
Hi, could you get me to the airport as quick as you can? I'm in a hurry. I want to catch a flight. Here you go. Thank you.
TWA flight 626 is now boarding at 8:21.
Hello, Croswell Industries.
Hi, yes, messages for Susan Warfield, please.
I'm sorry, Miss Warfield doesn't work here anymore.
What? What do you mean?
I'm awfully sorry to have to tell you this, but Miss Warfield died in the hospital 2 days ago.
Television.
Sorry, honey, you're too late. The apartment's rented. These furnished places, they go quick.
The woman who lived here, her belongings.
I heard she died. Not in the apartment, though.
Thank God.
Do you know who took them?
Oh, maybe it was the same people who towed a car away this morning. That's the manager. Maybe he knows.
Excuse me. May I help you? Are you checking in?
No, I just need some information. A friend of mine died here last Monday.
I'm very sorry. What was the patient's name?
Susan Warfield. She was admitted here for an ulcer operation on the night of the 14th, and something went wrong.
Excuse me. Will you step back here for a moment, please? Our Mrs. Connors will take care of you.
Just step over here.
Hi. You're inquiring about Susan Warfield?
Yes, ma'am.
I'm afraid we can't comment on that particular case.
Why not?
Well, perhaps one of her relatives can help you with the details.
She didn't have any family.
Well, then I think you've got her mixed up with someone else.
Where is she? Where is her body?
According to this, it was removed and taken to the Seaview Memorial Chapel in Pacific Palisades. Well, they couldn't have picked a lovelier spot.
Would you please wait for me?
I gotta charge you for that, lady.
I don't care. Keep the meter running, then.
Are you one of the bereaved?
No. I actually came here for another funeral. Susan Warfield. I was told that she was brought here.
Yes, I'm afraid you're too late. That service was this morning early. It was held outside at our meditation point. Quite a beautiful spot.
Well, who made those arrangements?
That was her brother.
Her brother?
Mm-hmm.
That can't be because she doesn't have a brother.
Oh, I assure you, I met the gentleman. Everything was paid for by cashier's check by Mr. Aaron Warfield.
Aaron Warfield? There is no such name.
Well, it was an exceptionally nice casket, considering it to be a cremation.
Left?
Many people choose to scatter the ashes out over the ocean. I do hope he returns or gives us some instructions. We have a lovely meditation spot just 50 yards from the chapel, just for that purpose.
It wasn't even that serious of an operation.
Well, the doctors made a mistake, didn't they? Or at least that's what was said in the Times.
The Times?
Well, you know how hospitals are when things go wrong.
Thank you.
I can see you were very close to Susan. My deepest sympathy.
$37. Will you stop at the next automated teller, please?
Yes, ma'am.
No.
Thomas A. Rutherford, attorney for the family of the deceased Susan Warfield, has filed a $10 million suit in Superior Court. The 24-year-old patient allegedly received transfusions of the wrong blood type during surgery, leading to her death within minutes. Thomas A. Rutherford. Question about the law. I'm writing a paper.
You're a writer.
Well, I'm trying to be. Actually, it's for a class.
Oh, I'm a student myself, third year law at Loyola.
Shh.
So, what do you want to know?
Okay. Well, say a guy loans his friend a medical insurance card for an operation. That's a crime, isn't it?
Insurance fraud is a felony punishable by up to 5 years of prison. But I don't think anybody gets that. Figure out maybe 2 years at the most.
Okay. Well, what if that friend dies in the hospital?
Well, if it were determined that the deception somehow contributed to the death of the patient, that changes everything. We're talking involuntary manslaughter now.
Manslaughter?
Yeah, figure on maybe 5 years.
Thank you.
The court has reviewed the documents, and I'll take the matter under advisement.
Your Honor, we're citing the People versus Wagner, California Supreme Court decision, April 1989. It's a clear precedent in this matter.
This court will decide what's a clear precedent in this matter, Mr. Rutherford. We'll adjourn until 2:30.
Excuse me, Mr. Rutherford. Your office said that you would be here all day, and so I came down here
to make an appointment if you have anything to do.
It's about the Susan Warfield case.
Yes, yes. What about Ms. Warfield?
She was a friend of mine. I'm Nicole. Nicole Grace.
It's all right, Nancy. And how long had you known her?
Well, she was only here a few months.
So you didn't know her very well?
Yes, I did. We went everywhere together.
Did you visit her in the hospital?
Well, I had been out of town for a few days. It wasn't until I got back that I found out.
Found out what?
Well, that she had died.
Your lunch date is waiting.
I've only got a couple of minutes. So you were not aware that she had gone into the operation?
Well, I knew she wasn't feeling well.
Well, it's the most blatant case of negligence I've ever seen in a major city hospital. Even after she went into convulsions, they continued to pump 2 more units of the wrong type of blood into her veins.
Did they find who was responsible for this?
Well, I'm not at liberty to go into details, but I'll tell you, we will make an example out of them. We're suing for $10 million. Wrongful death of a young person. It's mostly punitive damages, and we'll get it.
Now, you represent her brother, Aaron.
What's her half-brother? Her father had been married before. But from what he tells me, he and Susan were quite close.
Yes, she spoke of him often. She said he was a great guy.
Please, have a seat. He flew in from Miami as soon as he heard the terrible news, and he immediately asked us to represent the family.
Listen, is there any way I can see Aaron? I'd like to express my sympathy.
Sure. Nancy, what's Mr. Warfield's hotel?
Park Manor in Santa Monica.
Park Manor.
Thank you.
As far as we know, aside from the peptic ulcer, Susan was in excellent physical condition.
Yes.
But she jogged, she rode her bike, she went to the gym, things like that.
Yes, sir, she did.
It seems odd that she told her supervisor at work that she'd gone to the hospital for female problems when actually it was an ulcer.
Maybe he misunderstood.
I see. Well, thank you very much for coming in. Miss. We may need you to testify at a deposition, just to her general good health and her favorable mental outlook. I mean, she had everything to live for.
Yes, she did.
Yeah. Nancy, could you get her number, please?
Thank you.
Thanks again for coming in. I want an investigator put on this Nicole Grace. Have them find out everything they can about her.
Right away.
Have them assign Cochran. He's their best man. The girl was scared of something.
Excuse me.
Yes, ma'am?
I am so embarrassed. The clerk just gave me Mr. Warfield's room number, and I went and forgot it.
That's no problem. I'll look it up for you. You wait right here.
Thank you.
That's Warfield?
Yes.
Excuse me. Keller Morton Warfield, 210.
Who is it?
Hello, Mr. Warfield.
You sure you got the right room?
I was looking for Mr. Warfield.
You must want Aaron. He's up in 415. One of the better beachfront rooms.
You're Aaron's father?
Guilty as charged. Although I wouldn't want to brag about it. Let me give you some advice. If Aaron doesn't know you're here already, you just take on off and forget having anything to do with him. He doesn't treat his women decent.
Did you come out here from Florida with him?
Why don't you come on inside?
I was a friend of your daughter's.
It's odd hearing someone describe her like that. All these years, I never even thought of having a daughter. Should have at least sent her a card on her birthday.
Now I can't even remember when her birthday was.
August 20th, 1970.
I never even told her mother I'd been married before and had a kid. I guess I didn't want her to know I'd run out on him.
Well, you finally got to know your son, didn't you?
Huh. He tracked me down years ago. He needed money.
Weren't you ever curious about your daughter?
Oh, I never let it bother me. Not until Aaron called and said she was dead. Told me to get on the next plane.
Aaron was already here?
Folks back in Houston wrote us Susan's mother passed on. Left her house she got more than 100,000 for. Oh, that's all Aaron had to hear.
So he was here looking for her.
Well, they're related by blood. Damn if I could ever see any resemblance between them.
You actually saw her?
At the funeral. I got them to open a coffin a minute. I'd seen her last as a baby. And then I saw her dead. She must have been just under two. Little girl standing on a porch. Her whole face twisted up crying as I drove off. Well, I spent the better part of 22 years trying to forget that little face. Was she a nice girl?
She was very nice.
Do you recall her ever mentioning me?
No. Never.
Should she?
Mr. Warfield, did Aaron ever get to meet his sister?
Well, he was too late. Hell, he would have only tried to hit her up for a loan.
Is he upstairs in his room?
Nah, he goes in to see that damn lawyer almost every day.
My name's Nicole. Nicole Grace. This is my number. Please call me before you go back to Miami.
I won't be here that long. Rutherford just wants the insurance people to meet a grieving old man that just got over a stroke.
There was a patient on this floor, Susan A. Warfield. And
sorry, I can't discuss her. There's a litigation and we're forbidden to say anything.
Yes, I understand. I was just wanting to know. I know she was given the wrong blood type. Do you know how that could possibly happen?
I told you. We have specific orders. I can't say anything, miss. I'm sorry. No, excuse me.
She give you a hard time?
Well, she's probably afraid to say anything.
It's a big secret. They already fired. The guy that screwed up.
They did? Do you know who it was?
Yeah, some idiot lab technician named Garcia. He entered the poor girl's blood type into the program backwards. It was supposed to be blood type A negative, and he documented it as B negative.
So a man punches a wrong key, and a patient dies?
I got x-ray film.
Excuse me. Pardon me. Hi. I have a delivery for a Mr. Eddie Garcia, and he's got to sign for it.
Eddie, he used to work across the hall, but he won't be coming back.
Any idea where I can get it to him?
Sorry.
It's okay. You can sign for it.
What am I going to do with it?
Well, I can't take it back.
Just a minute. And don't touch anything in here. Miss?
Yes.
4420 Western Avenue. That's where he lives.
Glad I get paid by the mile. Is that his computer?
As a matter of fact, it was. Why?
Thank you. Mr. Garcia, I got your address from the hospital, and I was wondering if I could speak with you.
Okay, I hear you.
Hello.
Who are you, anyhow?
Actually, I'm writing a story on the death of Susan Warfield, and I was... Oh, please don't close the door. I just want to know what happened.
They had to blame somebody.
I don't blame you, Mr. Garcia. May I come in?
You want to write something? I'll give you something to write. I've done that same job every day for 5 years, and I have never made a mistake. Never.
But the entry on the computer was wrong.
Yeah, damn straight it was. Somebody changed it.
Well, how could they?
Well, I don't know how, but they did.
On purpose?
Don't look at me like that. I'm not crazy. And I didn't kill that poor girl.
Are you saying that someone actually wanted to give her the wrong blood type? You're talking about murder.
Look, you're not going to write about this anyway, okay? So why don't you just leave me alone? Go away.
Well, why didn't you call the hospital then? Or call the police?
Because it is technically impossible. I am the only one with the access code. Nobody but me can get into that system.
Well, I saw where you worked. Anyone can walk up and down that hall and see what you're doing.
What are you talking about?
If someone was watching and you punch in the same exact entry code over and over again...
Yeah. Yeah, I must enter those same four digits at least 50 times a day.
What?
No, nothing.
No. You're remembering something, please. Anything.
Well, there was some guy. It could have been that morning, or maybe not. But he was standing right behind me, and then when I finally turned around to look at him, he said something about being lost.
What did
and
this man look like?
I don't know.
Well, if you saw him again, would you recognize
him? Well,
how
do I know? I was busy. I only glanced at him.
What do you need to access the file?
Just the patient's registration number, but anybody can get that. It get it right off the wristband.
Turns out Susan had a brother.
The one who's suing the hospital?
And I think you need to take a look at him.
You believe me, don't you?
It scares me, but I do. I need your phone number.
555-8167.
8167.
Are you going to write this up? Are you going to print this?
I'll be back.
Oh boy. Are you all right?
I didn't hit your car, did I?
No. But you've got to be the world's worst driver. Does your Jeep only go in reverse?
You sure didn't hit your car?
It wouldn't matter if you did. This car's a loaner. My car's in the shop. Somebody hit me.
Could you please move it? Thank you.
Is he looking for you?
Yeah, I got a lot of parking tickets.
Move that vehicle now.
You better get in.
What?
Come on, I'm aiding and abetting. Hurry up.
Can get away. Are you going to tell me who you are?
Nicole. Nicole Grace.
Name fits. Just toss those cans in the back of the body.
Drop me off any place.
Since I saved you from incarceration, can I buy you dinner?
No, thanks. Maybe some other time.
If you're going to be running from the police, you got to keep your strength up.
I can't believe you're doing this for me.
Did you ever do something stupid for somebody you liked?
How can you like me? You don't even know me. And who will I be dining with?
I'm Ron. Ronnie Holden. And these are the magic piano fingers of Ronnie Holden.
I'm not much into jazz music. Are you famous?
Very. Mm. No, I play piano with the Johnny Hayes Quintet. Out in the valley on weekends. Maybe you'll come see me.
Sometime I will.
I can't believe it.
What?
You know, sometimes you get an image of a person you'd like to meet, the way she'll look and dress, and all of a sudden you see that person.
I don't always dress like this.
Here's to friendship.
Lost a very good friend.
I'm sorry. I knew something else was bothering you. I guess you don't want to talk about it. Your gardener die?
What do you think they did with my car?
Well, they probably impounded it. Hey, any place you need to go?
Oh, no, thanks. I'll be fine. And thank you again for dinner. I really appreciate it. Good night.
Night. Would it be impolite to ask for a cup of coffee? I got a long ride back to Sherman Oaks.
Sure. Door's open. No. Ron, don't go in there.
Don't worry. If you hear me yell, run like hell. Anybody here?
Be careful.
There's somebody in the living room.
The kitchen's around the corner.
Safe. There's no one here.
You're right.
You really need a light for that hallway.
sorry. Well, thank you.
You want to call the police? Reported burglary? I didn't think so.
Well, it doesn't look like they took anything.
How can you tell?
Yeah, I know it's a mess.
Thank God there's no room in the closets for anybody to hide.
Somebody breaks into my apartment and you're amused?
I'm sorry. You know why? You gotta look at my car. I feel like I'm at home.
It's okay, I'm sorry. I'm just a little upset right now. I'm gonna be okay.
Every woman I ever lived with was a neat freak. They all got sick of picking up after me and walked. But I was an amateur. You're a professional.
Would you get serious? He could come back here.
Any idea who? An ex-boyfriend, maybe?
I think I know exactly who did it.
Maybe you want me to stay a little while.
I could promise you some coffee.
I'll make it. Where is it?
In the kitchen. Oh, Ron. Thanks for everything you did today.
I'm going out of my mind with curiosity. You gotta tell me what's going on here. I know you really want to.
As a matter of fact, I do.
You only met Susan a few weeks ago. There are probably lots of things she never told you about.
I am positive she didn't know anything about a half-brother.
How can you be so certain of that?
Look, Eddie Garcia remembered a man watching him behind his computer. Now, if it was Aaron, and if we can prove that he was at the hospital that morning... What?
You said we.
Did I?
You shouldn't have been running from the police. You should have gone to them.
Well, I can't right now.
Why not?
I just can't, that's all.
You know, if you really think this phantom brother of hers broke in here, he already knows you've been asking questions.
Can you fix the damage to my front door?
I'm not too handy. Okay, now this is home security. This should keep an intruder out for a good 12 seconds. I don't like leaving you here alone.
Oh, I'll just sleep with a kitchen knife under my pillow.
Look, I can crash on the couch. It's no problem. Okay, I won't push it. Suppose I come back in the morning and bring breakfast.
I think that's a great idea. And would you pick me up some film for my camera?
What do you have in mind now?
Go to the hotel, snap a picture of Aaron, show it to Eddie Garcia.
Oh, and he's not supposed to notice you madly snapping away? Look, I better go with you, just in case.
I was hoping you'd offer.
Lock the door.
I noticed your cupboard was bare.
Oh.
Feeling any better?
Yes, I am, thanks.
I'm good.
You know what you said last night about going with me to see Aaron?
Did I agree to that? Too much sake, I guess. I didn't forget. Film, plus batteries for the flash.
You are so reliable.
You had a visitor last night. Big guy. In a raincoat.
How do you know?
I ran him up.
You were outside all night?
I didn't feel like driving all the way back to the valley in the rain.
What am I going to do with you?
What are you going to do without me?
Maybe you should be a cop.
Okay. You phone him up. Ask him to come down to the lobby.
Ring room 415, please. What'll I say?
But you have documents from the attorney's office that need to be signed. Anything to get him down here so I can get a quick snap of him.
Well, I guess it was too much to expect he'd be here.
Well, we can either wait here in the lobby till he gets back, or we can try to get inside his room.
Whoa! You really want to get inside his room?
Well, he broke into my place first, didn't he?
Do you mind if I have an idea for a change?
Why, what are you going to do?
Excuse me. Can I have my key, please? Room 415.
Here you are, sir.
Thank you.
How'd you do that?
I asked for it. Like I said, please.
I'm impressed.
What was the idea?
12. Or 15.
Hold it.
Hello? Hello, we're breaking into your room.
When he arrived.
Take that. I better keep an eye out in case he decides to come back. What are you gonna do?
Search his place from top to bottom.
Fine. Just hurry up.
Speed it up, please.
I don't know what I'm doing out here. I don't even know what he looks like.
Now you will. I found the picture. That's his dad beside him.
Looks like a pretty big guy. It's a good thing he didn't show up.
I want to call Eddie Garcia. Where is the phone? There it is.
Wouldn't you have to do it from here?
Hello?
Hello, Mr. Garcia. It's Nicole. I'd like to come back over and see you.
Now is not a good time. An investigator from some lawyer's office is here. He wants me to make a statement.
Listen to me. Don't say a word. I've got a photograph that I want you to look at.
All right. Okay. Call me back in a few hours, all right?
All right.
Can we get out of here now, please?
Yeah. So you know where Mercy Hospital is?
Yeah, the old hospital near the freeway.
All right.
Look, I don't care what you say. I'm not ready to make any statement. Not yet.
Who was that on the phone? It was a girl named Nicole, wasn't it? Don't lie to me.
Ron, I can get a lot more information if I'm alone.
I thought we were a team.
Well, I'll be finished here in, say, 2 hours.
I'll come back for you.
Okay. Did you see him hanging around on this floor, maybe on Monday?
Yeah, him I would have remembered. He looks kind of mean, but I like that. If you find him, give him my number.
Excuse me, would you just look at this one more time, please? Never saw him. But we're busy up here. He could have come and gone during visiting hours without being noticed.
Okay, well, if you don't mind, I'm going to hang around till the next shift gets here.
Excuse me, sir. Have you seen this man? Anywhere around? No? Thanks.
Mr. Garcia, I was with Nicole earlier when she phoned you.
Where is she? Is she with you?
Oh, she'll be here soon.
Did that investigator give you a hard time?
You know, he just might be back soon.
Did you tell him what you and Nicole talked about?
I don't know what you're talking about.
Sure you do. Don't you remember me, Eddie? You gave me directions. I know how you feel, Eddie. I got canned from a hospital, too. And in Miami. I was an ambulance attendant. He claimed I was stealing drugs. I always hated hospitals after that. People go there to get better. And they die.
Sorry I'm late. Traffic was murder.
Put your seatbelt on.
Went through the entire hospital with the photo until they finally asked me to leave.
You think somebody'd remember a big guy like that?
I'm sure Eddie will recognize him. It's gotta be him.
Where are we headed?
Western and Olympic. 4420 Western.
You think I can come inside with you this time?
No, I don't seem to have any luck without you.
It's all right. We'll talk to the cop. Stay here.
Excuse me.
Yeah.
Accident of some kind?
Would you please move on?
It was Edward Garcia. He jumped from the fire escape into a back alley.
Oh, God.
Don't fall apart on me now.
It wasn't any suicide. He was waiting for us. He would have identified the photo.
Do you want to talk to the cops? Show them the photograph?
No.
Why not? What's this big aversion to the police? What are you scared of?
Right now, there's nothing to tell them except you and I broke into a hotel room.
Didn't I tell you to move that car?
Take it easy. Take it easy. It's okay. When you phoned Eddie, was somebody with him?
Well, he said it was an investigator, but it could have been Aaron. Maybe he didn't recognize him after all.
Oh.
Yes, it's Tom Rutherford. I've been looking for your son.
I haven't seen him.
Well, there's been a major development. The technician whose negligence caused your daughter's death killed himself a few hours ago.
What? You mean Garcia?
He jumped off a fire escape a little while after my man finished questioning him.
Any confession?
Suicide note? Anything like that?
Well, that isn't necessary. His death is a clear admission of guilt. The attorneys for the hospital have asked me to come in. I think they're ready to settle.
Then I guess you won't be needing me anymore.
Well, your son does have power of attorney for you in this matter. If you'd like, he can sign off on your behalf.
I'll let him know what happened. I see him before I leave. So we get all that money?
Well, it looks like you do, yes.
Somehow it doesn't seem right.
I'm not leaving you alone tonight, Nikki. It's not safe.
I was going to ask you to stay.
You could use a drink if you had one.
I think I saw a bottle in the kitchen.
I'll get it.
Nikki, are you home? It's me, Jill. I need my red and white shoes back. Come on, Nikki. Be there. Oh, hell.
Why didn't you let her in?
You never would have gotten rid of her. Yes, Mr. Warfield, I'm here.
They don't need me here anymore. I'm booked on a flight back to Miami tonight.
Is there any way you can stay? I'd really like to see you again.
Ever since you came by, I've been thinking I should do right by Susan. Her ashes are still back at that chapel. There's a meditation point overlooking the ocean. It's just down the road from the chapel.
Yes, I know the place.
It seemed like a beautiful spot to scatter her ashes. Do you think that's what she'd want?
Yes.
As a baby, she loved the ocean.
I remember holding her, trying to show her how to swim.
That little body in my hands.
It was one of the few things we ever did together.
There's something that I should have told you the first time we met.
I'll get a cab over there.
Maybe you could drive me to the airport afterwards.
May I bring a friend?
Of course you can. Is an hour enough time to get there?
Yes, I'll be there.
Thank you.
Thanks for counting me in.
I guess I can't do anything without you.
So why can't you trust me?
What do you mean?
It's not just traffic tickets. You're in a lot worse trouble with the law.
Yeah, well, what if I am?
Nikki, I like you the way you are. I don't want to change anything about you. You can tell me.
Look, it's much too complicated to explain right now.
Try.
Can we just get going? I told him we'd meet him down at the chapel.
We've got lots of time. Now tell me why you're so shy of the police.
All right. I guess this is what you want to hear. I'm on probation. For boosting stuff from the mall.
You did it more than once?
Started out with makeup and stuff. I don't know why. I don't need all that junk.
You did it for the kick, didn't you?
It wasn't a kick. When they arrested me, they put me in jail. I was so ashamed. I still am.
Don't you feel better getting that out? I don't look down on you for what happened. It only makes me feel closer to you. We can talk to each other, Nikki. And that doesn't happen very often. I think you feel it too. Now, what else did you do? I know there's more. Get it all out.
Can't we go?
What I can't figure out is if Susan had been in LA only a few weeks, you couldn't have known her all that well.
Well, I've known you 2 days and you're already finding out everything about me.
What was she like?
She was quiet. She was laid back. Not real sure of herself around people.
Not your type at all.
Well, I took her places, introduced her around. She was just starting to loosen up.
Did she offer to loan you money?
I never asked.
But you knew she had plenty. You had nothing.
Do you think I was using her?
Everybody uses everybody. I've got my selfish motives, too. I usually get what I want.
Can we talk about this later?
Later, maybe you won't need me anymore.
It's not so. You'll see he's not a bad person. You really feel sorry you never got to know his daughter.
Hey, I can't wait to meet him. Beautiful spot, isn't it? Let him wait.
Why are you looking at me like that?
You never had me fooled for a minute.
What?
I know you so well. I know exactly what you're after.
You do?
Of course I do. A piece of the action. If you go to the police, you get nothing. But you can shake Aaron and his father down for plenty.
Is that what you think I want?
They walk away with $10 million. That's about six after the lawyer's cut. They can afford to buy you off.
Ron, you've got this whole thing all twisted.
You can't con me, Nikki. I'm on your side. We're two of a kind. Hell, I'm looking to share everything I get out of this with you.
What you get out of this?
treated his goddamn physical therapist better than he ever treated me. I took this myself. It was right after he had a stroke and his beloved Henry got him walking again. They got to be quite a pair, him and Henry. Kind of enjoyed letting you push me around. But you're gonna like me much better from now on.
Aaron?
Always preferred. Ron. I'm sorry about the act. I had to find out if I could trust you. From the minute I busted into your apartment and started following you, I knew. We're two of a kind.
Yes, I suppose we are.
You were after some of Susan's money. But I had my eyes on more. I only asked to borrow a few thousand.
What's a few thousand to you? You've got plenty of it.
I don't want to talk about it anymore. I'm sick!
Little bitch wouldn't even look at me.
Why didn't you look at me?
Let me go!
I wanted to rip that IV right out of her arm and strangle her with it. I grabbed her wrist, and I looked at the ID bracelet she was wearing.
Let me go!
I knew what to do.
All right, little sister. Good luck on your operation.
I once worked in a hospital. I knew all about access codes. Talking about what he was going to do with those ashes till I was sick of hearing about it. Grieving father leaps to dad. Or 11.
Can we get away with it?
Let's find out. You gotta chill? Shake it like a leaf.
Yeah.
Instead of splitting the settlement with him, I'll be sharing it all with you.
It's a lot of money.
We'll never have to clean up after ourselves. We'll have maids do that for us. I want us to enjoy that money and never look back.
Well, you've earned it, Ron.
No. Us. Two people. Killing together.
Another funeral. I love flowers. They're so beautiful.
They die so quickly.
Get out of here! You gotta get out of here. He's gonna hurt you.
What?
He's gonna kill him like he killed Nicole. Come on. Come on, he's coming. Let's go.
Who are you?
Don't you know who I am? I'm Susan.
Why didn't you tell me?
I was going to tonight.
No hug for me? Susan? So that was Nicole in the hospital, wasn't it?
I really screwed up.
You killed that girl.
No wonder I always felt so close to you. My own flesh and blood. That's why you never let me touch you. You felt it too.
Let go of her!
It's a family reunion! Now I gotta kill you all over again. I work hard for my money.
I'll never identify you. You're already dead.
I've been wanting to do this since I was 10 years old. The money's just the icing on the cake.
Aaron!
The minimum bail set indicates the district attorney is sympathetic to your case. I believe I can plea bargain that down to a misdemeanor.
Hell, they ought to give her a medal.
Of course, you lose your job.
I deserve that.
That's two of us that's unemployed now.
Maybe we should leave them to get acquainted.
Thank you very much.
My pleasure.
I appreciate you looking after her.
Are you kidding? She saved me from being a party to a double homicide. You take good care of her.
There's a lot of your mother in you. I can see that now.
Did you know that she kept a picture of you?
All this time. I sure wasted a lot of years, didn't I? I could have had something. From now on, you don't have to be anybody but yourself.
My name is Nicole.
I was Susan's very good friend.
The court has reviewed the documents, and I'll take the matter under advisement.
Your Honor, we're citing the People versus Wagner, California Supreme Court decision, April 1989. It's a clear precedent in this matter.
This court will decide what's a clear precedent in this matter, Mr. Rutherford. We'll adjourn until 2:30.
Excuse me, Mr. Rutherford. Your office said that you would be here all day, and so I came down here
to make an appointment if you have anything to do.
It's about the Susan Warfield case.
Yes, yes. What about Ms. Warfield?
She was a friend of mine. I'm Nicole. Nicole Grace.
It's all right, Nancy. And how long had you known her?
Well, she was only here a few months.
So you didn't know her very well?
Yes, I did. We went everywhere together.
Did you visit her in the hospital?
Well, I had been out of town for a few days. It wasn't until I got back that I found out.
Found out what?
Well, that she had died.
Your lunch date is waiting.
I've only got a couple of minutes. So you were not aware that she had gone into the operation?
Well, I knew she wasn't feeling well.
Well, it's the most blatant case of negligence I've ever seen in a major city hospital. Even after she went into convulsions, they continued to pump two more units of the wrong type of blood into her veins.
Did they find who was responsible for this?
Well, I'm not at liberty to go into details, but I'll tell you, we will make an example out of them. We're suing for $10 million. Wrongful death of a young person. It's mostly punitive damages, and we'll get it.
Now, you represent her brother, Aaron.
What's her half-brother? Her father had been married before, but from what he tells me, he and Susan were quite close.
Yes, she spoke of him often. She said he was a great guy.
Please, have a seat. He flew in from Miami as soon as he heard the terrible news, and he immediately asked us to represent the family.
Listen, is there any way I can see Aaron? I'd like to express my sympathy.
Sure. Nancy, what's Mr. Warfield's hotel?
Park Manor in Santa Monica.
Park Manor.
Thank you.
As far as we know, aside from the peptic ulcer, Susan was in excellent physical condition.
Yes.
But she jogged, she rode her bike, she went to the gym, things like that.
Yes, sir, she did.
It seems odd that she told her supervisor at work that she'd gone to the hospital for female problems when actually it was an ulcer.
Maybe he misunderstood.
I see. Well, thank you very much for coming in. Miss. We may need you to testify at a deposition just to her general good health and her favorable mental outlook. I mean, she had everything to live for.
Yes, she did.
Yeah. Nancy, could you get her number, please?
Thank you.
Thanks again for coming in. I want an investigator put on this Nicole Grace. Have them find out everything they can about her.
Right away.
Have them assign Cochran. He's their best man.
Good.
That girl was scared of something.
Excuse me.
Yes, ma'am?
I am so embarrassed. The clerk just gave me Mr. Warfield's room number, and I went and forgot it.
That's no problem. I'll look it up for you. You wait right here.
Thank you.
That's Warfield?
Yes.
Excuse me. Keller Morton Warfield, 210.
Who is it?
Hello, Mr. Warfield.
Sure, you got the right room?
I was looking for Mr. Warfield.
You must want Aaron.
He's up in 415. One of the better beachfront rooms.
You're Aaron's father?
Guilty as charged.
Although I wouldn't want to brag about it. Let me give you some advice. If Aaron doesn't know you're here already, you just take on off and forget having anything to do with him.
He doesn't treat his women decent.
Did you come out here from Florida with him?
Why don't you come on inside?
I was a friend of your daughter's.
It's odd hearing someone describe her like that. All these years, I never even thought of having a daughter. Should have at least sent her a card on her birthday.
Hell, I can't even remember when her birthday was.
August 20th, 1970.
I never even told her mother I'd been married before and had a kid. I guess I didn't want her to know I'd run out on him.
Well, you finally got to know your son, didn't you?
Huh. He tracked me down years ago. He needed money.
Weren't you ever curious about your daughter?
Oh, I never let it bother me. Not until Aaron called and said she was dead. Told me to get on the next plane.
Aaron was already here?
Folks back in Houston. Rhoda Susan's mother passed on. Left her house she got more than 100,000 for. Oh, that's all Aaron had to hear.
So he was here looking for her.
Well, they're related by blood. Damn if I could ever see any resemblance between them.
You actually saw her?
At the funeral. I got them to open a coffin a minute. I'd seen her last as a baby. And then I saw her dead. She must have been just under two. Little girl standing on a porch. Her whole face twisted up crying as I drove off. Well, I spent the better part of 22 years trying to forget that little face. Was she a nice girl?
She's very nice.
Do you recall her ever mentioning me?
No. Never.
Well, why should she?
Mr. Warfield, did Aaron ever get to meet his sister?
Well, he was too late. Hell, he would have only tried to hit her up for a loan.
Is he upstairs in his room?
Nah, he goes in to see that damn lawyer almost every day.
My name's Nicole. Nicole Grace. This is my number. Please call me before you go back to Miami.
I won't be here that long. Rutherford just wants the insurance people to meet a grieving old man that just got over a stroke.
There was a patient on this floor, Susan A. Warfield. And
sorry, I can't discuss her. There's a litigation and we're forbidden to say anything.
Yes, I understand. I was just wanting to know. I know she was given the wrong blood type. Do you know how that could possibly happen?
I told you. We have specific orders. I can't say anything, miss. I'm sorry. No, excuse me.
She give you a hard time?
Well, she's probably afraid to say anything.
It's a big secret. They already fired the guy that screwed up.
They did? Do you know who it was?
Yeah, some idiot lab technician named Garcia. He entered the poor girl's blood type into the program backwards. It was supposed to be blood type A negative, and he documented it as B negative.
So a man punches a wrong key, and a patient dies?
I got x-ray film.
Excuse me. Pardon me. Hi. I have a delivery for a Mr. Eddie Garcia, and he's got to sign for it.
Eddie, he used to work across the hall, but he won't be coming back.
Any idea where I can get it to him?
Sorry.
It's okay. You can sign for it. Here.
What am I going to do with it?
Well, I can't take it back.
Just a minute. And don't touch anything in here. Nothing. I got 20 things here. This?
Yes.
4420 Western Avenue. That's where he lives.
Glad I get paid by the mile. Is that his computer?
As a matter of fact, it was. Why?
Thank you. Mr. Garcia, I got your address from the hospital, and I was wondering if I could speak with you.
Okay, I hear you.
Hello.
Who are you, anyhow?
Actually, I'm writing a story on the death of Susan Warfield, and I was... Oh, please, please don't close the door. I just want to know what happened.
They had to blame somebody.
I don't blame you, Mr. Garcia. May I come in?
You want to write something? I'll give you something to write. I've done that same job every day for 5 years, and I have never made a mistake. Never.
But the entry on the computer was wrong.
Yeah, damn straight it was. Somebody changed it.
Well, how could they?
Well, I don't know how, but they did.
On purpose?
Don't look at me like that. I'm not crazy. And I didn't kill that poor girl.
Are you saying that someone actually wanted to give her the wrong blood type? You're talking about murder.
Look, you're not going to write about this anyway, okay? So why don't you just leave me alone? Go away.
Well, why didn't you call the hospital then? Or call the police?
Because it is technically impossible. I am the only one with the access code. Nobody but me can get into that system.
Well, I saw where you worked. Anyone can walk up and down that hall and see what you're doing.
What are you talking about?
If someone was watching and you punch in the same exact entry code over and over again...
Yeah. Yeah, I must enter those same four digits at least 50 times a day.
What?
No, nothing.
No. You're remembering something, please. Anything.
Well, there was some guy. It could have been that morning, or maybe not. But he was standing right behind me, and then when I finally turn around to look at him, he said something about being lost.
What did
and
this man look like?
I don't know.
Well, if you saw him again, would you recognize
him?
Well,
how do I know? I was busy. I only glanced at him.
What do you need to access the file?
Just the patient's registration number, but anybody can get that. It get it right off the wristband.
Turns out Susan had a brother.
The one who's suing the hospital?
And I think you need to take a look at him.
You believe me, don't you?
Scares me, but I do. I need your phone number.
555-8167.
8167.
Are you gonna write this up? Are you gonna print this?
I'll be back.
But they're talking about operating.
Look, you've got some of the finest doctors on staff here. You're lucky.
They're gonna find out.
They won't. The worst part is over. You've been admitted. Look, my company has paid a fortune in medical. I've never used a dime.
Shh.
Nobody's gonna get hurt.
They're ready for her upstairs.
Hi, Susan. I'll talk to you in the morning. She'll be all right now. So, how long do you plan to keep her?
It's a standard procedure of maybe 3-4 days, a week tops.
A week?
I hope it's not a serious operation.
No. Some female problems. Mm. But I'll be back in a week.
No, don't you worry about anything around here. Just relax and get better.
Thank you. I would appreciate it if you didn't mention the details to anyone. It's kind of personal.
I'll respect your privacy. Just check in with your voicemail at the office from time to time to pick up any messages.
Yes, sir.
I lucked out. There's nobody else in the room.
Great. Well, I took medical leave from work, and I'm going down to that place that you told me about in Scottsdale.
What, the Delray?
Yep.
Oh, you're gonna love it.
I figure that way I won't run into anyone here when I'm supposed to be in the hospital.
Hey, you know what? You should see the surgeon that came in to brief me. It's this Greek guy. He's about 6'2". He's divorced. He's definitely interested.
Yeah, well, don't you get interested, because remember, you're me.
What if somebody finds out?
I won't.
But what if somebody phones the room?
Will you tell the nurses that you're not accepting any calls, period?
But then how am I going to talk to you?
Call me in Scottsdale. You're going to be out of there before I even get back.
God, Susan. I mean, nobody's ever done anything like this for me before. Ever. Not even my own family. Look, I just wanted to tell you that I'll always be there for you. Always.
Bye, Susan.
Bye-bye, Nikki.
Hi, yes, this is Bungalow 7. I'd like to make another credit card call to Los Angeles, please.
Okay, go ahead. Mercy Hospital.
Hi, third floor nurses station, please.
One moment, please. Nurses station.
Yes, I've called several times about Susan Warfield, and I can't seem to get any information.
Well, we're not permitted to give out information about a patient.
Listen, I know she's not taking any calls, but could you just tell me if she's been released yet?
Who is this, please?
I'm a friend. Is there something the matter? I know she had an operation on Monday.
Just a moment.
Now, who is this speaking, please?
What's going on? I just want to know if Susan Warfield's been released.
I really need for you to identify yourself. Hello?
You can just put that suitcase in the back seat, please.
Right away.
Hi, could you get me to the airport as quick as you can? I'm in a hurry. I want to catch a flight. Here you go. Thank you.
TWA flight 626 is now boarding at 821.
Hello, Croswell Industries.
Hi, yes, messages for Susan Warfield, please.
I'm sorry, Miss Warfield doesn't work here anymore.
What? What do you mean?
I'm awfully sorry to have to tell you this, but Miss Warfield died in the hospital 2 days ago.
Television.
Sorry, honey, you're too late. The apartment's rented. These furnished places, they go quick.
The woman who lived here, her belongings.
I heard she died. Not in the apartment, though.
Thank God.
Do you know who took them?
Oh, maybe it was the same people who towed a car away this morning. That's the manager. Maybe he knows.
Excuse me. May I help you? Are you checking in?
No, I just need some information. A friend of mine died here last Monday.
I'm very sorry. What was the patient's name?
Susan Warfield. She was admitted here for an ulcer operation on the night of the 14th, and something went wrong.
Excuse me. Will you step back here for a moment, please? Our Mrs. Connors will take care of you.
Just step over here.
Hi. You're inquiring about Susan Warfield?
Yes, ma'am.
I'm afraid we can't comment on that particular case.
Why not?
Well, perhaps one of her relatives can help you with the details.
She didn't have any family.
Well, but then I think you've got her mixed up with someone else.
Where is she? Where is her body?
According to this, it was removed and taken to the Seaview Memorial Chapel in Pacific Palisades. Well, they couldn't have picked a lovelier spot.
Would you please wait for me?
I gotta charge you for that, lady.
I don't care. Keep the meter running, then.
Are you one of the bereaved?
No. I actually came here for another funeral. Susan Warfield. I was told that she was brought here.
Yes, I'm afraid you're too late. That service was this morning early. It was held outside at our meditation point. Quite a beautiful spot.
Well, who made those arrangements?
That was her brother.
Her brother?
Mm-hmm.
That can't be because she doesn't have a brother.
Well, I assure you, I met the gentleman. Everything was paid for by cashier's check by Mr. Aaron Warfield.
Aaron Warfield? There is no such name.
Well, it was an exceptionally nice casket, considering it to be a cremation.
Left?
Many people choose to scatter the ashes out over the ocean. I do hope he returns or gives us some instructions. We have a lovely meditation spot just 50 yards from the chapel, just for that purpose.
It wasn't even that serious of an operation.
Well, the doctors made a mistake, didn't they? Or at least that's what was said in the Times.
The Times?
Well, you know how hospitals are when things go wrong.
Thank you.
I can see you were very close to Susan. My deepest sympathy.
$37. Will you stop at the next automated teller, please?
Yes, ma'am.
Thomas A. Rutherford, attorney for the family of the deceased Susan Warfield, has filed a $10 million suit in Superior Court. The 24-year-old patient allegedly received transfusions of the wrong blood type during surgery, leading to her death within minutes. Thomas A. Rutherford. Wondering if I could ask you a question about the law. I'm writing a paper.
You're a writer?
Well, I'm trying to be. Actually, it's for a class.
Oh, I'm a student myself, third year law at Loyola.
Shh.
So, what do you want to know?
Okay, well, say a guy loans his friend a medical insurance card for an operation. That's a crime, isn't it?
Insurance fraud is a felony punishable by up to 5 years in prison, but I don't think anybody gets that. I figure out maybe 2 years at the most.
Okay. Well, what if that friend dies in the hospital?
Well, if it were determined that the deception somehow contributed to the death of the patient, that changes everything. You're talking involuntary manslaughter now.
Manslaughter?
Yeah, figure on maybe 5 years.
Hey, look, lady, could you step back from the road, please?
Hey, Nikki. Hey. Looking good.
Thanks.
But this car is a disaster.
Maybe you can find me a new one when I come out?
Anything for you.
I'll wipe it off. Hey, Jimmy, it's me. I'm sorry. Excuse me, I'm sorry. Oh, God. Don't move, you'll tear it.
I think my hair's caught on your pin.
Easy.
Okay, there.
God, thanks. You saved my life. This dress has got to go back to the store tomorrow.
Are you alone tonight, Nikki?
Not exactly.
Hey. How long have you been trying to get in?
Forget it. I really want to go home.
No,
thanks.
Don't be silly.
Come on, come with me. Excuse me. Okay, she's with me.
How am I supposed to know?
I'll get yours.
Put it away around here. It's going to be embarrassed if we see pay.
Hello, how are you?
Look, I'm Nikki.
Nicole Grace.
I'm Susan Warfield.
You just visiting L.A.?
No, I moved here a couple months ago from Houston. And some friends at work thought it was time that I get out for an evening.
Yeah, and then they don't show up. Some friends, huh? Here, try some of this. Actually, let me. It's what I do for a living anyway. Sit down. Close your eyes.
You know, I'm a makeup artist. Rock videos, commercials. Whatever comes up, really.
Wow.
It's much better.
They should let all those people in outside. There's not that many people here.
Yeah, but they always do that. I mean, give this place a month. It'll be dead. Watch.
can really take that dress back after you've worn it?
Little trick. See that? You've got a lot to learn. Come on.
Notice the guy over there in the white vest?
Yeah.
He had a quadruple bypass last August, right?
Now he hits on everything that walks.
Thumped his wife and kids. He's a real loser. Come on, let's go up to the VIP section.
So how do you meet anyone nice?
You looking for somebody nice?
Honey, there are no real men in L.A.
All the guys out here hit on you right away. They think it's expected of them. You just have to put them in their place.
Don't you have any regular boyfriends back in Houston?
Well, there was Roy. Mm-hmm. He took off when my mom got sick.
Then he shows up a couple of days after the funeral, heard that I'd sold the house, and suddenly he was just dying to marry me.
So you packed up and moved. You let him run you off?
No, I wanted to get away anyhow. You know, go someplace where I could start over.
Look, if you want things to be different, you've got to start being in control. Instead of always heading for the nearest exit.
Hey, Nikki.
What?
Don't forget, 10 o'clock, Sunday night, Larry's house in Bel Air.
Yeah, I got it. Look, if you're not doing anything, there's this great bash in Bel Air on Sunday night. Lately, I can't get a job, but I'm on everybody's guest list.
Yeah, maybe I could go.
Do you have anything a little hotter to wear?
Well, you're welcome to come over to my house and look in my closet.
Not a chance.
You know, I hadn't bought much clothes since my mom died. I always felt it was still her money. Did you see this?
Hey, is that her picture?
Yeah, when she's about my age.
She's pretty. Is that your father?
You know, I never knew she kept a picture of him until I was going through her things. And there it was.
He looks really nice.
Yeah, he took off when I was about two. He went to work on some oil rig in Florida. We never heard from him since.
Guess you don't have any brothers or sisters, though.
Nope, just me.
Did you ever think about him when you were growing up?
Nah. Hurt too much.
But you kept his photo. Do you have a glass of milk?
You have an ulcer, and you're still smoking and drinking. Avoid taking this medication with alcoholic beverages.
Look, it only flares up every once in a while. I'm fine.
What do your doctors say?
They say pay the bill. Ulcers are for rich people. I can't afford that.
I'm gonna drink your milk.
Come on. We're gonna go over to my place. We are gonna create a new you.
Come on. Your landlord provide you with a gardener?
What landlord? This place belongs to a couple backup singers in a heavy metal band. They went on tour, so I inherit the key, which I always keep right here under this plant. That way I don't lose it.
Well, that's dangerous.
Enter at your own risk.
Have you been robbed?
It always looks like this.
Well,
come on, can I help it if there's not enough closet space? Guys take one look and they flee into the night.
So you live here alone?
Yeah, just me and my stuff. I mean, I can't help it. I accumulate things. I just can't see throwing anything away.
Ah, got it. Look, killed it.
What was my eyelash?
Oh, gosh. I could have sworn it moved. Sorry. Nicole, look at all these parking tickets. These can turn into warrants. You could get arrested.
Really?
Yes, ma'am.
Thanks for pointing that out. See, I told you my stuff would fit you.
Yeah, you know, it's not really me.
Yeah, but, I mean, that's the idea. After a while, you even start to feel different.
Well, I'm kind of naked in here and...
Okay, wait. Here, try something else. How about this?
That's kind of cute.
We have to do something with your hair. Not bad.
Hello, Susan speaking. Hey! No, I'll pick you up for a change. You drove all last week. Wow, it's the biggest house I've ever seen. So what does this Larry do?
Nobody knows. And nobody asks. Don't be nervous. Lenny, I hope he had us here tonight.
Yeah?
Come on.
Hey, do you notice my eye makeup is better?
Oh, you look great.
Thanks.
Hey, Lori.
Hi.
This is my friend Susan.
Nice to meet you, Susan.
Wow, I'm starving.
No, thank you.
Oh, thank you.
You don't need that.
I'm not your mother. You don't have to take care of me. God, I'm sorry. I didn't mean to hurt your feelings.
Oh, no. Get it.
Still friends?
Yeah, still friends.
What am I saying? You don't even know me?
Yes, I do. I know you're a good person.
Not a very good judge of character, are you?
What do you mean?
Care to know about the real Nikki? All those sordid little details? I got arrested 7 months ago for shoplifting. Costume, jewelry, makeup. God knows I don't need any more makeup. I couldn't make bail, so I went away for nearly a month. I was really ashamed of myself.
And you're still running around with parking tickets? You're gonna get picked up again.
Why do I do that to myself?
I don't know. But you know what? I'm not gonna let you do it anymore.
I mean, it's funny. Because I know everybody. And you're the only one I could tell.
What? What's wrong?
God, my stomach. I think I need to sit down.
Okay. Let's go. Got it. I'm gonna take you to the emergency room.
What's the matter? Is she okay?
Yeah, she's fine, thanks. Let's get your coat. Is it getting worse?
Oh, God, just get me there.
Thank you. Almost there. Okay, let me just sit you down, and then I go get take care of everything. Right. Just stand there. Come here. Come here. Excuse me, I hate to interrupt you, but my friend is having an ulcer attack.
Has she vomited up blood?
No, she hasn't.
Has she coughed up anything that looks like coffee grounds?
No, I don't think
all
so.
Right,
but
well, fill out this form and have really a seat over there, and we'll see you as soon
she's
as
not
we can.
Able to walk.
Ever since my husband lost his job, we don't have no medical insurance.
I wish I could help, but I have to refer you to County General.
That place is like a zoo, full of homeless and drug addicts. You could wait all night.
There's really nothing I can do for you here. It's the rules.
Wait, what's happening? Where are we going?
Well, we have to go to County General.
No, you can't. Come sit down, please. Just for a second.
Really?
Okay.
Excuse me, sir. She's really sick. Can she sit down, please?
Thank you.
Thank you so much.
Okay. Oh, I knew they wouldn't help me.
They would if you had insurance. It's one thing I have plenty of from work.
What good's that?
Excuse me, she made a mistake. I need another one. Thank you.
What are you doing?
Shh. Just for tonight, you have to be me. Susan A. Warfield.
Are you crazy?
Birth date? August 20th, 1970.
No way, Susan. You'll get in trouble.
Shh. No one will ever find out. Things will get treated right away.
No way. Come on.
Come on. We'll try to make it to the car. We will go down.
Nicole?
We'll go down.
Not a chance. Stay here. No one's ever gonna know. This is gonna get you in. Okay, hold on.
I can't believe you're doing this. Thank you. Thank you.
Excuse me. Here's her paperwork and her insurance card.
Let me make a copy of her card.
How long will it be?
We'll call Miss Warfield as soon as we can.
Oh, God.
Just driver's license and Social Security. That's all they're going to ask you.
I got it down.
Just keep looking at it.
Miss Warfield?
Right here.
We're ready for you now.
Leave your purse with me.
Are you waiting for Miss Warfield?
Yes, I am. How is she?
We've lavaged her stomach. There's no internal bleeding now, but the x-rays reveal perforations in the lining and air up underneath her diaphragm.
What does that mean?
It means we're going to have to admit her. A laparotomy is indicated, and we'll know more in the morning.
An operation? Can I see her?
Yeah, maybe you can calm her down. Yeah. Unfortunately, a young girl like that with an ulcer is probably under a lot of pressure. We'll take care of it. Order a type and screen on that blood?
Yes, doctor.
I want to go home.
There's nothing to worry about. If we have to go in, the incision won't be that bad. We'll clip the nerve, causing the secretion of excess stomach acid, and this condition probably won't recur.
You've got to get me out of here. The worst thing we can do is panic. They'll get suspicious, and then where will we be? Do that.
I asked for it. I said please.
I'm
impressed. What was the idea?
Hello, we're breaking into your room.
What if he's dead?
Look! Ron! His flight information. I can prove when he arrived.
Decides to come back. What are you gonna do?
Search his place from top to bottom.
Fine. Just hurry up. Speed it up, please. Doing out here. I don't even know what he looks like.
Now you will. I found the picture. That's his dad beside him.
Looks like a pretty big guy. It's a good thing he didn't show up.
Let's go.
I want to call Eddie Garcia. Where is he? Follow me. There it is.
Don't you have to do it from here? Hello?
Hello, Mr. Garcia. It's Nicole. I'd like to come back over and see you.
Now is not a good time.
An investigator from some lawyer's office is here. He wants me to make a statement.
Listen to me. Don't say a word. I've got a photograph that I want you to look at.
All right. Okay. Call me back in a few hours, all right?
All right.
We get out of here now, please?
Yeah. So you know where Mercy Hospital is?
Yeah, the old hospital near the freeway.
Right.
Look, I don't care what you say. I'm not ready to make any statement. Not yet.
Who was that on the phone? It was a girl named Nicole, wasn't it? Don't lie to me.
Ron, I can get a lot more information if I'm alone.
I thought we were a team.
Well, I'll be finished here in, say, 2 hours.
I'll come back for you.
Okay. Did you see him hanging around on this floor, maybe on Monday?
Yeah, him I would have remembered. He looks kind of mean, but I like that. If you find him, give him my number.
Excuse me, would you just look at this one more time, please? Never saw him. But we're busy up here. He could have come and gone during visiting hours without being noticed. Okay, well, if you don't mind, I'm going to hang around till the next shift gets here. Excuse me, sir. Have you seen this man? Anywhere around here? No? Thanks.
Is it?
Mr. Garcia? I was with Nicole earlier when she phoned you.
Where is she? Is she with you?
Oh, she'll be here soon.
Did that investigator give you a hard time?
You know, he just might be back soon.
Did you tell him what you and Nicole talked about?
I don't know what you're talking about.
Sure you do. Don't you remember me, Eddie? You gave me directions. I know how you feel, Eddie. We got Ken from the hospital, too. Out of Miami. I was an ambulance attendant. He claimed I was stealing drugs. I always hated hospitals after that. People go there to get better. And they die.
Sorry I'm late. Traffic was murder.
your seatbelt on.
Went through the entire hospital with the photo until they finally asked me to leave.
You think somebody'd remember a big guy like that?
I'm sure Eddie will recognize him. It's got to be him.
Where are we headed?
Oh, Western and Olympic, 4420 Western.
You think I can come inside with you this time?
No, I don't seem to have any luck without you.
Excuse me.
Yeah.
Accident of some kind?
Would you please move on?
Was that Rick Garcia? He jumped from the fire escape into a back alley.
Oh, God.
Don't fall apart on me now.
It wasn't any suicide. He was waiting for us. He would have identified the photo.
Do you want to talk to the cops? Show them the photograph?
No.
Why not? What's this big aversion to the police? What are you scared of?
Right now, there's nothing to tell them except you and I broke into a hotel room.
Didn't I tell you to move that car?
Take it easy. Take it easy. It's okay. When you phoned Eddie, was somebody with him?
Well, he said it was an investigator, but it could have been Aaron. Maybe he didn't recognize him after all.
Oh.
Yes, it's Tom Rutherford. I've been looking for your son.
I haven't seen him.
Well, there's been a major development. The technician whose negligence caused your daughter's death killed himself. Few hours ago.
What? You mean Garcia?
He jumped off a fire escape a little while after my man finished questioning him.
Any confessions?
Suicide note? Anything like that?
Well, that isn't necessary. His death is a clear admission of guilt. The attorneys for the hospital have asked me to come in. I think they're ready to settle.
Then I guess you won't be needing me anymore.
Well, your son does have power of attorney for you in this matter. If you'd like, he can sign off on your behalf.
I'll let him know what happened.
If I see him before I leave. So we get all that money.
Well, it looks like you do, yes.
Somehow it doesn't seem right. I'm not leaving you alone tonight, Nikki. It's not safe.
I was going to ask you to stay.
Use a drink if you had one.
I think I saw a bottle in the kitchen.
I'll get it.
Nikki, are you home? It's me, Jill. I need my red and white shoes back. Come on, Nikki. Be there. Oh, hell.
Why didn't you let her in?
Never would have gotten rid of her. Thanks. I can't now, Ron. Not now.
It's like I got to do. Let it ring.
Yes, Mr. Warfield, I'm here.
They don't need me here anymore. I'm booked on a flight back to Miami tonight.
Is there any way you can stay? I'd really like to see you again.
Ever since you came by, I've been thinking I should do right by Susan. Her ashes
are still back at that chapel.
There's a meditation point overlooking the ocean. It's just down the road from the chapel.
Yes, I know the place.
Seemed like a beautiful spot to scatter her ashes. Do you think that's what she'd want?
Yes.
As a baby, she loved the ocean. I remember holding her, trying to show her how to swim.
That little body in my hands.
It was one of the few things we ever did together.
There's something that I should have told you the first time we met.
I'll get a cab over there.
Maybe you could drive me to the airport afterwards.
May I bring a friend?
Of course you can. Is an hour enough time to get there?
Yes, I'll be there.
Thank you.
Thanks for counting me in.
I guess I can't do anything without you.
So why can't you trust me?
What do you mean?
It's not just traffic tickets. You're in a lot worse trouble with the law.
Yeah, well, what if I am?
Nikki, I like you the way you are. I don't want to change anything about you. You can tell me.
Look, it's much too complicated to explain right now.
Try.
Can we just get going? I told him we'd meet him down at the chapel.
We've got lots of time. Now tell me why you're so shy of the police.
Okay. All right. I guess this is what you want to hear. I'm on probation. For boosting stuff from the mall.
You did it more than once?
Started out with makeup and stuff. I don't know why. I don't need all that junk.
You did it for the kick, didn't you?
It wasn't a kick. When they arrested me, they put me in jail. I was so ashamed. I still am.
Don't you feel better getting that out? I don't look down on you for what happened. It only makes me feel closer to you. We can talk to each other, Nate.
Oh, my God, Mr. Langford. Come on, light. Turn green.
You all right?
I didn't hit your car, did I?
No. But you've got to be the world's worst driver. Should people only go in reverse?
You sure I didn't hit your car?
It wouldn't matter if you did. This car's a loaner. My car's in the shop. Somebody hit me.
Could you please move it? Thank you.
Is he looking for you?
Yeah, I got a lot of parking tickets.
Move that vehicle now.
You better get in.
What?
Come on, I'm aiding and abetting. Hurry up.
Can get away. Are you gonna tell me who you are?
Nicole.
Call Grace.
Name fits. Just toss those cans in the back of the body.
Drop me off any place.
Since I saved you from incarceration, can I buy you dinner?
No, thanks. Maybe some other time.
If you're going to be running from the police, you got to keep your strength up.
I can't believe you're doing this for me.
Didn't you ever do something stupid for somebody you liked?
How can you like me? You don't even know me. And who will I be dining with?
I'm Ron. Ronnie Holden. And these are the magic piano fingers of Ronnie Holden.
I'm not much into jazz music. Are you famous?
Very. No. No, I play piano with the Johnny Hayes Quintet. Out in the valley on weekends. Maybe you'll come see me.
Sometime I will.
I can't believe it.
What?
You know, sometimes you get an image of a person you'd like to meet. The way she'll look and dress. And all of a sudden you see that person.
I don't always dress like this.
Here's to friendship.
I lost a very good friend.
I'm sorry. I knew something else was bothering you. I guess you don't want to talk about it. Gardener die?
What do you think they did with my car?
Oh, they probably impounded it. Hey, any place you need to go?
Oh, no, thanks. I'll be fine. And thank you again for dinner. I really appreciate it. Good night.
Night. Would it be impolite to ask for a cup of coffee? I got a long ride back to Sherman Oaks.
Sure. Door's open. No. Ron, don't go in there.
Don't worry. If you hear me yell, run like hell. Anybody here? Where's the man living?
The kitchen's around the corner.
There's no one here.
You're right.
You really need a light for that hallway.
Yeah, sorry. Well, thank you.
You want to call the police? Report a burglary? I didn't think so.
Well, it doesn't look like they took anything.
How can you tell?
Yeah, now it's a mess.
Thank God there's no room in the closets for anybody to hide.
Somebody breaks into my apartment and you're amused.
I'm sorry. You know why? You gotta look at my car. I feel like I'm at home.
It's okay, I'm sorry. I'm just a little upset right now. I'm gonna be okay.
Every woman I ever lived with was a neat freak. They all got sick of picking up after me and walked. I was an amateur. You're a professional.
Would you get serious? He could come back here.
Any idea who? Next boyfriend, maybe?
I think I know exactly who did it.
Maybe you want me to stay a little while.
I'm gonna promise you some coffee.
I'll make it. Where is it?
In the kitchen. Oh, Ron. Thanks for everything you did today.
I'm going out of my mind with curiosity. You gotta tell me what's going on here. I know you really want to.
As a matter of fact, I do.
You only met Susan a few weeks ago. There are probably lots of things she never told you about.
I am positive she didn't know anything about a half-brother.
How can you be so certain of that?
Look, Eddie Garcia remembered a man watching him behind his computer. Now, if it was Aaron, and if we can prove that
he was at
the hospital that morning... What?
You said we.
Did I?
You shouldn't have been running from the police. You should have gone to them.
Well, I can't right now.
Why not?
I just can't, that's all.
Now, if you really think this phantom brother of hers broke in here, he already knows you've been asking questions.
Can you fix the damage to my front door?
I'm not too handy. Okay, now this is home security. This should keep an intruder out for a good 12 seconds. I don't like leaving you here alone.
Oh, I'll just sleep with a kitchen knife under my pillow.
Look, I can crash on the couch. It's no problem. Okay, I won't push it. Suppose I come back in the morning and bring breakfast.
I think that's a great idea. And would you pick me up some film for my camera?
What do you have in mind now?
Go to the hotel, snap a picture of Aaron, show it to Eddie Garcia.
Oh, and he's not supposed to notice you madly snapping away? Look, I better go with you, just in case.
I was hoping you'd offer.
Lock the door.
I noticed your cupboard was bare.
Oh.
Feeling any better?
Yes, I am, thanks.
I'm good.
You know what you said last night about going with me to see Aaron?
Did I agree to that? Too much sake, I guess. I didn't forget. Film. Less batteries for the flash.
You are so reliable.
You had a visitor last night. Big guy. In a raincoat.
How do you know?
I ran him out.
You were outside all night?
I didn't feel like driving all the way back to the valley in the rain.
What am I going to do with you?
What are you going to do without me?
Maybe you should be a cop.
Okay. You phone them up. Ask them to come down to the lobby.
Ring room 415, please. What do I say?
But you have documents from the attorney's office that need to be signed. Anything to get them down here so I can get a quick snap of them.
Well, I guess it was too much to expect he'd be here.
Well, we can either wait here in the lobby till he gets back, or we can try to get inside his room.
Whoa! You really want to get inside his room?
Well, he broke into my place first, didn't he?
Do you mind if I have an idea for a change?
Why, what are you going to do?
Excuse me. Can I have my key, please? Room 415.
Here you are, sir.
Thank you.